What is up, guys? Welcome to this episode of LangyBot.
Yeah!
Now, guys, today we're going to be talking about some of our worst ever job experiences.
Oh, man. Now, one of my first jobs was I was a lifeguard.
Uh-huh.
Being a lifeguard takes a lot of training. You got to get CPR certified. It's not a joke.
Well, you got to guard people's lives.
You got to be responsible for people's lives. During lifeguard school, during the whole training, I thought, oh man, I'm gonna be on a sunny beach. I'm gonna be like those people you see in the movies, you know, running in slow motion to save some girl from drowning, you know,
from a shark attack.
Yeah, I'm gonna punch a shark and save a life. It was gonna be sick.
Uh-huh. Okay?
That's all I was thinking. But when I actually did get my certification, they randomly assign where each lifeguard goes to, like, as far as, like, pools, okay, within the city. I got assigned to a city pool, so it was, like, a very small indoor pool, a lot of kids screaming all day. I got a headache pretty fast, and all you do all day, right, is just sit there, right, and just hope that nothing goes wrong,
okay?
So one day, I'm sitting in the adult pool, okay? This is where the adults swim and, like, the swim teams train. I was like, this is gonna be an easy shift. Nothing's gonna go wrong. So I was sitting in the adult pool, and one of the local high schools, their girls' diving team was there that day, okay? Because there's, like, the adult pool, and there's, like, a big, like, a really deep pool with, like, a diving board,
uh-huh.
You know, for, like, team. So they came and I was like, okay, you know, this is gonna be a super easy shift. They are trained divers. They know how to swim. It's not gonna be a problem. Okay?
Right.
So, you know, for a few of the girls go, I'm like, okay, this is cool, whatever. I'm chilling. But then suddenly, this one girl gets up on the diving board and looks a little bit nervous. And I'm like, you know, she's probably just like a freshman on the high school team. It's
uh-huh.
the varsity team. It's
uh-huh.
probably real intense. She gets up on the board, right? She gets up and so she does a dive where she's facing towards the board. So then she's standing at the tip of the board. She's facing like basically backwards. Like she's looking backwards
uh-huh.
down the board, okay? So she's gonna do this simple dive where you just jump up and then you tuck forward and you go down into the water. It was a very simple dive. I was like, nothing's gonna go wrong, okay?
Uh-huh.
She jumps off, form looks real good, and then she tucks, and I hear a clap as she goes down into the water. So I'm not gonna lie, I was only paying half attention because I was pretty bored. Okay, I had not had any food on that shift. I was feeling a little bit lightheaded, okay? I was like, I don't really know what just happened, but you know, again, they're trained divers, it's probably nothing. She climbs up out of the pool and looks okay. I was like, oh, okay? No, I mean, nobody else did anything. Her diving coach.
Did anyone else hear that loud noise?
I think everybody did, but nobody said or did anything. So I was like, okay? Yeah, I must have imagined it. I don't know. So I wait, everybody, all the girls get their turn, they go. And then this girl gets up there again. And now this time, I'm not trying to make it obvious, but I'm watching her. I'm trying to, because I don't want to be like a creep, like staring at the girls
just
diving.
Staring at her.
I didn't want to be that guy. But I was like, I'm watching in case you hurt yourself. So she gets up on the board, does the same dive again. And this time I see it very clearly. She jumps up in the air, tucks herself, and then hits her forehead on the diving board and it gets in the water. I'm like, wait a minute. So I blow my whistle. Hey, get out of the water, okay? I sit her down and I go, did nobody else see that? What happened? And the diving instructor goes, no, we all saw it the first time, but you didn't do anything, so we thought it was okay. So then my manager came up to me after that shift and said, Justy, you should have done something after the first time. You in trouble.
You were the lifeguard.
Yeah.
And because you didn't say anything, they were just like, oh, I guess it's all right for her to concuss herself.
I guess so. And I also got in trouble. Wait. It was the worst day ever.
Did you get to keep the job?
Yes, but after that, I was moved only to the kiddie pool where all the kids are screaming. It was terrible.
Okay, now speaking of watching over sports teams and keeping everything safe, I actually, for real, used to be a soccer referee.
Oh.
Now, I was 12 years old, and at this time, it's hard to get a job.
Dude,
at like 12 years old.
They let a 12-year-old refereeing the World Cup?
No. I was refereeing like kids younger than me. I went to this training because I was like, dude, I really want money to buy stuff like Pokemon cards or like I have a phone or stuff like that. I was like, how do I get money? I need a job. Who's going to hire me? Basically no one.
Yeah.
But my sister was a soccer referee and she was like, oh, you should also try it.
Oh, it's a family trade. Yeah.
That sounds easy. You blow a whistle, you tell kids which way the ball goes in the game. That's easy, right?
That's the whole job?
Well, the refereeing was actually one of the worst jobs I've ever had in my life.
Why?
So I went through this like 2-week training course where they teach you all the rules of soccer. You have to learn like all even like the tiny little rules that no one knows. You have to learn all those. They test you on them.
Okay.
They like bring you out to a soccer field and be like, what should you do in this situation? It's like a boot camp
they
for referees.
They make you do that to referee toddlers?
Yeah. So I go to this whole training camp. I'm like, I'm about to be a soccer referee. This is going to be sick.
Oh, yeah.
I have the yellow uniform. It's going to look cool. So I go out. And I have my first game. It was a 7-year-old soccer team.
Okay.
So it's a team of 7-year-olds versus another team of 7-year-olds. It's my first game ever. I'm feeling real nervous.
Yeah, I would be too. You know, I'm scared of 7-year-olds.
And I remember my mom drove me to the soccer field where this game was taking place. I was shakily taking my whistle out, putting on my soccer shoes, and she was like, do you want me to stay for the game? Because when you referee, if you make a bad call, sometimes the parents will like yell at you. They'll be like, bad call, referee! Or like, they'll like tease you. For real.
They'll be like, wow, that referee is a big net. And that was a bad call.
Like, if you make a bad call, the coach will yell at you. And I don't like being yelled at.
Yeah.
So she was like, would it make you feel better if I like stayed and like...
She was like, would it make you feel better if I held your hand? Yeah. Did you referee the first game with your mom just standing holding your hand?
No.
And then someone was like, hey, bad call. Your mom's like, shut up! Yeah, is that what happened?
I wish.
Oh, yeah.
That would have been awesome.
Yeah, true.
But unfortunately, that is against the rules to have your mom on the field.
Really?
Unless she's a player on your team.
She might be. Okay.
My mom was like, Adam, it's okay. Like, don't get nervous. Like, I'll just be there on the sidelines, like, watching you. If any of the parents, like, say anything bad, I'll kind of, like, teach them to not say that. So, like, if someone's like, hey, bad call, my mom will be like, oh, it wasn't that bad of a call. Like, trying to, like, you know, keep people happy, right?
Yeah, hey, that ref's got a big neck. It's only kinda long.
At that age, there's, like, two halves. So the first half goes great. It's halftime. I blew the whistle. I'm like, whew. I'm doing great, Mom. I'm feeling really good.
Yeah.
The game is tied at like 2-2. It was actually a pretty intense game considering they were 7-year-olds. But it's the second half and I'm like, okay, I'm in the clear. All I gotta do is just not mess up.
Yeah.
It was a tied game. As I said, it was 2-2. And there was like maybe 2 minutes left in the game.
Okay.
And the kid is like, this kid's dribbling a soccer ball down the field. I'm like running next to him, kind of watching him. So he's like this kid who's like bigger than a lot of the other kids. He's like dribbling the soccer ball down the field. And like one of the defenders comes up to him and the kid like kind of like shoves him out of the way and then kicks the ball and scores it. And that's like that point will win them the game.
Okay.
So then I'm forced to be in this position where I was like, did he foul the kid or should I count this as a goal?
What did you do?
I ended up counting it as a goal.
Wow.
Because I didn't want the kid to push me. Because he was like my size. And like, okay, when I was like, goal, half the team was like, yeah, nice job.
Yeah.
And the other team that was now losing was like, are you kidding me? They started screaming at me. They was like, ref, that was a foul.
Yeah, that was a foul.
Are you blind?
Yeah.
They were screaming at me, dude. And I was so nervous. I'd like turn bright red. My mom was just on the sidelines, like not even sure what to do.
Little did you know, Adam.
What?
That 7-year-old on that fateful day was me. It was a foul. I fouled that kid. I said, there's no way he's gonna call this.
And I did it.
Yeah.
And that's how we met.
Yeah.
No, it's
not. That would be so funny. I'm just imagining you calling it as a foul and the kid bumps you. And then your mom comes in and bumps the kid. Like, don't bump my son.
Basically, how that story ended was I quickly ended the game. I left as quick as I could and I just cried on the way home. Because I was just like, I don't know what to do. I don't know if I think this job is good for me. It was really, really sad. But I was like, I was so stressed out.
Did you actually cry?
Yeah. But I did end up getting like better as a referee. Like that was my first game. I ended up being a referee for like 3 years and I got way better at it.
Yeah.
But that first game literally scarred me and I almost just quit right there.
Wow. Good thing you didn't, Adam. You know, that foul, that play you told me about reminds me a lot of me in the cafeteria.
What do you
know, when I see those nuggets, that pizza, those corn dogs, get out the way!